So when we had March through June, there basically was an effective national lockdown that in some ways worked and other ways didn't work. But now that we're far past that period, that's not even sort of up for debate right now. And the thing that is probably allowing President-elect Biden to sort of thread this needle is the fact that he isn't going to come into office until late January. The period where this is going to get particularly bad, sort of during the Thanksgiving and holiday season period, that's when this is going to be terrible, and that's when these cities like Philadelphia, New York, et cetera, are going to have to figure out what they're going to do. But if we're looking at February 2021, that won't make any sense given the sort of state of where the country is going to be.
Yeah,
that's right.
Roger, what do you think are the major challenges that this Biden administration will face immediately upon coming into office? I mean, obviously the pandemic, but what are some of the challenges specifically involved in getting a vaccine out to people? We got good news today that we could have a vaccine as soon as December that starts going out to our most vulnerable populations. But distributing that in a fair and equitable and efficient manner is quite a challenge. Then you have the negotiations with Congress if there's going to be another stimulus package, which, you know, I think trying to tangle with Mitch McConnell and getting anything done through that body is going to be extraordinarily difficult. Lay out what that landscape looks like a little bit for us.
Well, they're both kind of known unknowns, to use a Rumsfeldian kind of term, in that we don't know the results of Georgia, so it's tough to really look into January and get a sense of what the Senate is going to look like. And then far more serious and far more annoying and infantile is the complete opaque nature of the relationship between the Biden folks and the Trump folks right now, because the Biden people are unable to answer these questions right now. To dial back a little bit, Marshall mentions the March through June period. I remember with great fondness the press conference in the Rose Garden on, I believe, March 6th of this year with a bunch of the corporate CEOs, and there was going to be testing sites in all the parking lots of the box stores and all these other things. My point in this is that if these folks had taken this seriously and had actually constructed that kind of testing capacity, which, as we know now, they decided to not do because testing impacted the president's numbers, we would actually have in place a distribution mechanism, right? You would have all those tents, all those army facilities, all those box store parking lots, and then that had been doing the testing, and then the vaccine is just new blood in those veins of a pre-existing structure. So in a sense, it's additionally frustrating that when literally lives are in the balance, and you can take every day now that the transition is underway, and you can
Milan
add that
Center
onto
FGZ, January, onto inauguration type diamond
day.
To 43
days
miles
past
north
the
of Alpha
election,
Oscar
20
02.
Days past
request
the inauguration, when we actually could be up to speed. This could be in place now, and it's unfortunate that you know, there's not an appetite on the part of the administration to actually do the right thing by the
Squawk 2633 FGZLU 12.
Specifically, I mean, is there going to be any political incentive to work together
whatsoever, or
is it fairly
arbitrary
to construct that kind of bad new structure?
Stuck in the obstruction part because, and this is why I think the most
copy FGZLU 12
Trump administration is coming to this issue, which is they became a hypercultural issue. So if you're a Republican senator and you're looking at the fact that Philadelphia is planning a degree shutdown, what I would want is for the federal government to provide support for the actual workers who are sort of packing the holiday restaurants that are going to shut down in the city. But if you're a Republican senator, what I'd probably say is, why should we support blue state shutdown, red states are shut down at the same time. So that cultural aspect is really the thing that we all sort of on this show talk about. When you dive into these culture wars, it's just not going to end up well for anybody, especially workers.
Yeah, we showed the results of polling from around the world, showing that we had the greatest partisan divide in this perception of how the government is handling coronavirus. Just one more indication of how.
Can I add one thing, Marshall's point?
Yeah, of course. How every
very quickly. It's particularly frustrating for me when people talk about bailing out blue states and blue cities. 13 of the 15 states most dependent on the federal government are red states. And so the South Carolinas, the Louisianas, and the Mississippis can't put on their pants in the morning without the Connecticuts and the New Yorks and the Massachusettses of the world. The blue states bail out red states almost every single day. And this idea, which is getting to your point, Marshall, about injecting politics into this, it's so unfortunate when people try to disingenuously portray blue states as going hat in hand to red states, when factually and statistically and policy-wise, it's exactly the opposite.
I tend to fall in this category. Look, no red and blue states in the middle of a pandemic or a crisis failing.
All right, guys, we're with our panel for that.
AO02 contact Switzerland Center on 126.35.
For FGZLU-12. Switzerland Center FGZLU-12 11,900 feet.
FGZLU-12 Switzerland Center, continue as planned. Altimeter 0.38.
Switzerland Center FGZLU-12 cancel flight following.
FGZLU-12 Switzerland Center cancellation received. Squawk 1200. Frequency change approved.
Zion approach FGZLU-12 is type Diamond to 410 miles north of Alpha Oscar 02. Request flight following. Squawk 1401 FGZLU-12.
FGZLU-12 radar contact 10 miles north of Alpha Oscar 02 12,900 feet. Altimeter 0.38.
Copy FGZLU-12. Going to 124.925 FGZLU-12. Milan Center FGZLU-12 13,900 feet.
FGZLU-12 Milan Center, continue as planned. Altimeter 0.38. FGZLU-12 contact Switzerland Center on 126.35.
FGZLU-12.